Hello and welcome back to Hella V. I am once again your host, Joe, and we're going to continue with Final Fantasy Tactics here. I have a new microphone, so this is a learning experience for me. Let's see how this works out. I was headed down to Tiger here. Does man become wild if all rationality is taken away from him? The answer is no. This is because he doesn't have grace. What? Okay. Fair enough. Yeah, girlfriend bought me a new mic. I'm digging it so far. Blue Yeti. Respectable brand. Okay. I looked at a map, and the maps I normally use off of Caves of Narsh don't really have a good layout of what's going on this stage. So I turned to other sources. All I can really tell for sure is that the map is roughly S-shaped.
To begin, draw an S for snake.
Yeah, conditions for winning defeat all enemies. That's sort of right. Okay, so according to my map, the four squares up here in the corner, all at 5 height, could have items. So I just need to have Celia walk on those. Behemoth. What am I up against here? I think I saw a dragon. Anyway, we got Scarlet the Samurai. I may rob her. Dark Behemoth. Oh, jeez. Stab up and sudden cry. Stab up, sudden cry on a regular Behemoth. And a dragon who only knows dash. Wow, what a terrible, crap, lousy dragon. 72. I do not trust this guy to not be getting out of the way before I finish jumping. So I'll just walk up in front of him. Take a swing. Walk over with her. Maybe throw a sword or something. Sure, have a javelin.
Oh, javelin.
How did I do all those night moves gags with candles, but not once did I do a reference to... Oh, Jesus, 420. Ugh. Smoke Rusty every day. Yeah, not once did I do a reference to Javelin by Bill Callahan. It's a great tune. You know what? I'm going to go back and put it in, and maybe you will all appreciate what I've done. Five and five, and walk up right beside him, and hit him with the old chakra, because, wow, Rusty got smoked. That's right, when you do 420 damage, that's what the episode turns into. Lol weed jokes, right? If there's one thing I've learned from Pokemon, it's the dragons don't like ice. At the same time, I don't like this fucking ridge in the way. I didn't even know that was there. Okay, can I tag... Take it easy, Candles. Alright, let's see how it works. Secret clothes! Alright, well, that's a good start. We've already got something. Haste yourself, rather than using quick, I will start with haste. Oh, Rusty can definitely jump on that dragon. And she can definitely throw a flail at that dragon. God, this is a... I'm appreciating the microphone. It's not like hanging off my face like my old headset was. I used to record off of a headset. This is still a little bit of a test, because I'll have to see what sort of reverb I get from the room. But the Blue Yeti has a directional component? Elixir! Hopefully that wasn't anything I really wanted. I don't even know what the loot here is. I've turned on the Blue Yeti's mono-directional nonsense. Oh! Officer Town! Give me the old revive. Get back up! Can you hit him with a potion yet? No. He's well out of range. Can you hit any of the enemies? No, there's a wall. Ugh, candles. Why didn't I give you teleport back? You'd actually be useful here if you had teleport. Yeah, well, that was my fool decision. Aw, yes. Okay. Okay, this is going very well. Oh my god. Okay, I just need to not die. Just don't die, and we'll be good. Let me consult my map here. Yeah, fucking game FAQs with the, you know, just absolutely pulling it out here. Okay, up around the corner here. There's possible squares where the exits can be. And, I don't know what clown at Caves of Narish decided that the best way to do this would be to, you know... Oh yeah, finish her off, Rusty. Some fool at Caves of Narish decided that the best way to display the map would be to actually take the isometric polygons from the game itself and just stick those in. And then try to, like, scribble on it. Just scribble. And I can see how you might think that's a good idea, sure. Unfortunately, it leads to situations such as, you know, when things are behind stuff. And you cannot see it. Make friends with the monster. Just friends, please. Can't even believe Japan. I can easily believe Japan. And how they would much rather... they'd much rather your character be a monster fucker than gay. Thank you, Japan, for that. And Phoenix Town. Okay. Okay, so the only thing that I didn't get here... That Phoenix Town could have been a cursed ring. Now... From the sounds of things, I might be better off not having picked that up. Candles, you're so slow! Okay. Not there. I'm just guessing at where these things are now. I don't need to do that. The map that I have is actually pretty good. Okay, the bottom corner. Both bottom corners. Okay. Oh, right, she doesn't have teleport on right now. She's got move, find, item. Okay, well, it'll be a million years before she gets over there. That's okay. That'll go off before anything. Jeez. Get candles in there. Rusty is still hurt. Okay, try down there. And there's the exit. We found a path that goes further on. That makes me wonder, what could the other squares have? I mean, I'm here, I may as well check it out. Right? Where is he going? Buddy, I don't know how to tell you this, but, you're gonna get shot. This will remove the charmed, but I don't care. Can Rusty hit him? No, no. But Rusty can discourage him. Don't step in front of candles. You'll get jumped on. That wouldn't be very fun. Okay, there's nothing there. Oh no, San Martino has just made himself a target. By that I mean I did it. Oops. Okay, well, good bluff, Rusty. God. I'm gonna have to switch out for that blast gun. Yeah. Move back two. There we go. Yeah, just to be safe, there's nothing here either. Oh, a crystal! Get a little bit light. Just a teeny bit. Just a little. Not enough to actually see. Why did Rusty take so much... I suppose the other one was a dark behemoth. Yeah, that's good. Give me all my magic points back. One, two, three, four, five, six. In theory, I should be able to jump this. And I can. Wave fist. Yeah, Hadouken right in your face. Eat my Hadouki. Oh, jeez. I was actually hoping to see Meteor. Oh, well. Oh, that'll be an interesting test. I just drummed my fingers on the desk. And I don't know if that's going to show up on the microphone or not. Yeah, but so far it's sounding pretty good. There's a little plug at the bottom of it for my headset to go into. Like, not my USB headset that I use for games. Because that's what I've been using to record, and it doesn't have great sound quality. I suppose I don't really know how good the sound quality on this one is, because this is still untested. This is the test. I hope you are all happy being the test audience. Ninja uniform, good for covert ads. Oh, always transparent. Always transparent. Okay. Wow. Right, I was going to give you the new gun. You've got the blaze gun. Now I have the blast gun. Gun that shoots lightning elemental bullets. Those bastards finally did it. Put lightning in a gun. Alright, you've got an angel ring on, so you always get back up when you get knocked down. Oh, that makes sense. But ignore... I don't know what the next level looks like. Geez, I wonder where this is a test. Should I call it there? Yeah, I'll just record one episode for the time being. I will save, of course. Cycle my saves. Holy crap, I got two things out of that. One of them is the lightning gun. I can't even believe my luck. What am I even looking at this shit for? Cecilia, you did nothing except for walk onto some very vital squares and find me the things I came in here for. Thank you very much. Master Squire, yeah, sure. I'm pretty sure all my guys can Master Squire at this point. He's already got it. Rusty, of course. 4,400. He can't Master Squire because there's one move that I can't get for him anymore. He's chemist. Okay. Yeah, you can learn everything you need. Oh, she could learn teleport if I so much wanted? Teleport's useful. Learn it. I'm gonna give him back teleport. But I'm not just gonna give teleport to everybody. That warrants another save, though. But yes, thank you for tuning in. I, once again, being your host, Joe. Oh, that reminds me. I was thinking about changing the branding on my channel. I don't know if it really matters doing a poll for it, because I've only got, like, 19 people watching these things at the moment. If even. So, a poll would probably not be representative of... You know, I probably got, like, 3 responses, I'll be honest with you. So I will not do a poll. Maybe I'll just see if I can, you know, be asked to do the thing. The Wednesday series. Okay. I haven't put anything up for a little while. I was hoping to get a new microphone, which I have now, to get better sound quality on my recording, for maybe a little something that's not just gameplay. You know, like when I first started the channel, I had the Let's Read series. I could do something like that again to fill time while I wait for an HDMI USB converter. Yeah, everybody's like, oh yeah, I totally just use the, what's the name of the thing? The Elgato capture card to do HDMI. And I'm like, that's great. That thing's like $200 Canadian. That's not happening. I don't have that lying around. You know, especially not considering I just bought a Switch. I have a Switch now. That's why I need the HDMI input, so I can get on this sweet Mario Maker action. I do intend, at some point on the weekend, to make a level to submit to the Beard Bros to play. Assuming they haven't closed their submissions for the first round already. They had 3 themes. And I think the last one that they're doing is 80s movies, and I kind of want to do an Escape from New York themed level. I have ideas. I do not have Isaac Hayes. We'll see how that turns out. Yes, thank you for tuning in. I have once again been your host, Joe, and see you next time.
Hey, I know you don't smoke weed. I know this, but I'm gonna get you high today. Cause it's Friday, you ain't got no job, and you ain't got shit to do.
It's the one and only Deco Double G.
Snoop Dogg! Snoop Dogg!
Da-da-da-da-da. You know what happened with the D.R.E.
Yeah. You know the West Coast.